week with outrageous action and sexy storylines.
Stacy Bliss trying to keep her top on.
But this unique sport, now known as Roller Jam, is nothing new. Coming up on the E! Original Special, the unbelievable story of roller derby, its rise to the top, its sudden death, and its recent rebirth.
That guy can fly!
Basically, I will stop at nothing to win a game.
I go by the motto, you know, shut up and win at all costs.
Just about everybody's going down except Logan Brown.
When they start cheating on me, it's when I start cheating on them. I get serious then.
Here comes Shea Brown, and look out! They're going to fight now. Shea Brown and Denise Logan.
After more than 25 years out of the spotlight, the roller derby is back on the track.
Oh, leapfrogs one and goes under the other.
The hard-charging, fast-action spectacle, renamed Roller Jam, is attracting a new generation of both skaters and viewers.
When I tell people that I do Roller Jam and I'm a professional inline skater for the show, they go, oh, like the old roller derby? And I say, yeah, you know, remember, except it's on inline skates now. They go, oh, that's cool. Do you really hit people? Do you get hurt? I'm like, yeah, look, I got lots of bruises.
Roller jam is a sport where two teams get on the track, put everything else aside, and just go at it for an hour. Beat each other up, get knocked down, beat up, in fights about personal vendettas.
Nobody's going to tell me that I can't skate. Doctors aren't going to tell me that I can't skate. A man is not going to tell me that I can't skate. This game is too big for the hot dice.
It is a combination of everything in X Games and extreme sports right now, and a little bit of WWF. There's hair pulling, scratching, clawing, you know, fist fights, cat fights. That's the best part about it.
Despite the violent brawls, breakneck speed, and outrageous storylines, Roller Jam does have rules. Two teams consisting of jammers and blockers compete against each other to score points. When the starting bell rings, the jammers attempt to circle the track as many times as possible, while the blockers try to stop them.
Jammers have 60 seconds to get around the track. For each person of the opposing team that they pass, they get a point. The object is to score points. The team with the most points at the end of the game wins.
I'm a jammer. My whole job is to score the points. The other guys, the blockers, their object is to keep me from scoring the points. So that's where we get the bangs and the elbows and the kicks and the body slams and everything else.
If the rules seem a little confusing, you're not alone. The players aren't quite sure of them either.
I wasn't aware there were any rules in Roller Jam.
We cheat at any chance we get.
There was a lead pipe laying on the track, and I used the lead pipe, and yeah, I got a penalty for that, which I thought was really unfair.
Here's the only rule. Watch your ass. That's the only rule that I play by.
Although the teams are co-ed, men and women don't compete directly against each other. But according to Keith Coppage, author of Roller Derby to Roller Jam, the sport is an equal opportunity injury.
They can reach speeds between 30 and 40 miles an hour on the track. It's extremely dangerous if you get hit and sent over the rail. You know, say whatever you want about the attraction of roller derby. That is tough.
In roller jam, if you go out there with the attitude that I'm going to get hurt, then you are going to get hurt. You have to step on the track with a totally no-fear attitude and just get business done.
I used to play football, but roller jam is way more damaging to the body than football ever will be and ever has been.
Whoever just took him out of the play!
You fall on the floor, you fall on a cement floor, it's tough, you're going to get hurt. It's a dangerous game.
I've separated my chest, I pulled three ligaments off my spinal column, I cracked all of my ribs. I dislocated both shoulders. I broke both my arms at one time. I broke my legs. I had my knees operated on where I tore the ligaments. The list can go on and on.
Despite the serious risks involved, or perhaps because of them, roller jam players all share an intense devotion to the game.
Yeah, I grew up watching roller derby, and it was really, you know, when people, kids are growing up, they have dreams and aspirations, and mine was to be a roller derby skater. I'm not sure what that says about me, but that's what it was.
I'm a person based on instincts and, like, intuitions and stuff, and the moment I saw it, I was like,
cool.
Right on. Get paid to skate and hit people. What else could you ask for? I tell everyone when they ask me, okay, what is it that draws you? I said, well, where else in a professional environment can you slug your coworker? And it's okay. There's no recourse.
Look at these two go at it. Blitz pounding the back of Francis' head.
Roller derby is referred to as sports entertainment, a form of competition that falls somewhere between Melrose Place and a monster truck rally. Just how much of the game is sports and how much is entertainment is debatable.
There is an element of entertainment to the show. The competition is totally legit, and there's an element of entertainment as well.
Oh, man!
I always compare it to, like, when Michael Jordan used to play basketball. I mean, sure, he could just run down, dunk it in, but he always put a little extra on it, and that's what you expect. And whenever you come to Roller Jam, you're going to expect that little extra, and we're always going to give it to you.
While the moves may be somewhat exaggerated, so are the rivalries between players.
And she does. She gets
the metamorphosis I go into when I step on the track, that I become big nasty. And no matter who I go up against, I'm going up against, you know, to beat him. And I really don't care if I win or lose, honestly. I just wanted to just pound him into the ground.
I like to classify everybody as, like, having two personalities. You have a personality on the track and off the track. So if you do something to me on the track and I'm mad, I'm going to go after you. But then afterwards, I'm going to be like, you know, hey, what are you doing? Want to go drink a beer?
Off the track, I'm a pretty friendly girl. I'm pretty easy to get along with. I like people in general. But once I get on the track, there's a whole other side of me that sometimes I didn't even know that I had. And I will do anything to win.
Although some elements of Roller Jam are embellished, viewers don't seem to mind. Games currently air twice a week on the TNN cable network, and ratings have been steadily climbing since its debut in January 1999. Psychiatrist Robert Butterworth believes viewers are tuning into the show because of its unpredictability.
A lot of people are bored with TV because most of it that they watch, they know what's going to happen. And I think there's an element of unpredictability in the roller derby. So in a sense, what we're really kind of becoming are folks that really want to see real life happening and in a sense, peeking in. So in a psychological sense, I think we're becoming a little bit voyeuristic.
Coming up, E! Gets more voyeuristic as we take an exclusive look backstage at the Roller Jam.
These are really good to hit people in the head with.
Plus, the women of Roller Jam reveal all.
I had a dream like this once.
But first, a look back at more than 60 years of skating, roller derby style.
In those days, too, I never even wore any padding or anything, and I always rolled my sleeves up and pulled my zipper down because that was just me.